In this video, I'm going to show you the goal of the IPC-A610 training and certification program, and we're starting right now. My name is Ramon Essos from ETECH-trainingen, and welcome to the second video of the IPC training and certification program. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more about the IPC training, soldering or other electronic stuff, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss anything. This is the second video in the IPC training and certification program series, and in this video we're going to talk about the IPC A610 training and certification program. If you're not familiar with IPC or the other training and certification programs, take a look at our other videos, and of course we will put a playlist link down in the description below with more information. Let's start with explaining what the IPC A610 training is about. The IPC A610 training is based on the IPC A610 standard, which explains the acceptability of electronics assemblies. The IPC A610 standard is the world's most widely used electronic assembly standard. It is an international recognized standard that is used by many production and assembly companies within the electrical and electronics industry to ensure the quality of their products. The goal of the IPC A610 training is to improve an individual's skill and ability to discriminate between acceptable and unacceptable electronics assemblies. Students don't just learn when an assembly should be acceptable or rejected, they learn the reason why. With every IPC training and certification program, there are three certification levels. If you like more information about the different certification levels, please watch the first video in this series after completing this video. The IPC A610 CIS training and certification course is an extensive 3-day paragraph by paragraph review of the IPC A610 standard. The CIT will also receive a review of the basic instructor skills so that the CIT knows how to conduct the CIS course. Depending on the certification level, at the conclusion of the course, all students will be subjected to an open book written examination, and the CSE and CIT will also receive a closed book exam. Students who successfully complete this course are awarded an IPC A610, CIS, CSE or CIT certification, which is valid for 2 years. For students who have previously achieved their IPC A610 certification within the last 2 years, a relevant recertification training course is available. The recertification training course must be followed within 6 months before the certification expires. Before we go deeper into the content of the IPC A610 standard, if you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Let's go deeper into the content of the IPC A610 standard and thus also the content of the training program for CIS, CSE and CIT. So what will you learn in this training course? In this training course you will learn the visual acceptable and reject criteria. Propose an application of the IPC A610. Hardware installation. Soldering criteria including lead-free connections. Solder connections requirements for plated through holes. Solder fillet dimension criteria for all major SMT component groups. Component mounting criteria for dips, socket pins and card edge connectors, and jumper wire assembly requirements. For a complete overview of all modules, please visit our website. The website address will be posted in the description below. So this was our video about the IPC A610 training and certification program. In the next videos, we will explain all the other IPC training and certification programs. If you have a topic you want us to make a video about, please leave a comment down below and maybe we will make a video out of this topic. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and see you next time.